Hello, you magical people. Welcome back on Salt and Sugar Saga. And today we are making eggless vanilla cake. So first thing first, we'll preheat our oven at 350 degrees Fahrenheit. And now we're gonna prepare our baking pans. So here I have taken 6-inch baking pan, which I'm gonna grease it with the oil spray and gonna line it with the parchment paper. And because I want my parchment paper to be greased from both of the sides, so I'm gonna flip it around now. That way I'm gonna get my clean parchment paper when I'm gonna remove it from the cake. So the baking pans are ready. Now we're gonna prepare our wet ingredients. For wet ingredients, we need oil. Should be flavorless, so you can use any flavorless oil, followed by some milk. Should not be cold, should not be hot, should not be warm. It should be at room temperature only. Followed by some yogurt or curd. Now we're gonna whisk all three ingredients until they are really mixed well. So we'll keep it aside and now we'll work on our dry ingredients. For dry ingredients, first thing first, we need our all-purpose flour or maida or plain flour, followed by baking soda, baking powder, a dash of salt, and some sugar. Guys, take care that whenever you are measuring your wet ingredients, use the liquid measuring cup, and when you are measuring your dry ingredients, use your dry ingredient measuring cup. Do not use one liquid one or a dry one for all the ingredients. Okay, so we have sifted all our dry ingredients. Now I'm gonna add my dry ingredients and my wet ingredients, and I'm gonna sift it one more time when I'm doing this. In that way, I'm removing all my lumps, if anything left. Now we're gonna fold in our dry ingredients into the wet ingredients with the help of a silicone spatula. And as you can see, we are using cut and fold method here to fold our dry ingredients into the wet ingredients. This is a basic vanilla base cake. You can just flavor it for any of the cake. If you are making mango cake, if you are making pineapple cake, if you are making mixed fruit cake, or even a strawberry cake, you can use this basic cake for all of your flavored cake. So now I'm gonna add some pure extract, vanilla extract. You try to use the pure one only, because pure one tastes way better than the imitated ones. Okay, so the batter is ready. Now I'm gonna pour the batter into the baking pans, which we have pre-lined. So I'm not gonna weigh them, I'm just keep an eye on them. So that's why I have used using this ladle, and approximately I have added 2 ladles in each of the pan. So here we have our cakes. Tap them. It's really important to tap to get a flat cake. So get set, bake. So I have baked them for around 25 minutes, and I'm gonna release the cake sides with the help of the butter knife, if anything is there. Okay, see how smoothly it came out. You see, the parchment paper is so clean and the cake is so soft and moist. And now we're gonna prepare our whipping cream for the vanilla cake. Guys, I have seen in many people, I have seen actually many people doing this process of whipping cream, that they'll take a big bowl, then add some ice in that, ice cubes, then they keep another bowl, then they'll add the whipping cream. Why to do that? Just keep your bowl in the freezer for 5 to 6 minutes and that's it. Add the whipping cream, add some sugar, whip, 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 and here we have whipping cream ready. And you'll know when your whipping cream is ready when you get the stiff peaks. Yes. And one more tip for you guys, that whenever you are buying confectioner sugar, take care, read the ingredients, that the confectioner sugar should consist of cornstarch or corn flour. That cornstarch will help your whipping cream to be stabilized on a firmer side. So I have placed one M piping tip in my piping bag or a star nozzle tip. Now I'm gonna fill my piping bag with the whipping cream and we're gonna layer our cakes. So you can see how firm and stabilized our whipping cream is. So now before layering, I'm gonna make sugar syrup. For that, we need 1/4 cup of hot water along with 4 tablespoons of granulated sugar, and we have to dissolve until the sugar is completely dissolved in the water and the water is clear. And the water should come at room temperature before you are soaking your layers. I'm gonna add a little whipping cream on my cake board so that the cake won't move while working on it. So I'm gonna soak my cake layer. Do not forget the sides of your cake. Guys, if you haven't subscribed yet, do subscribe my channel by clicking on the logo of Salt and Sugar Saga you can see at the end of the video, and do not forget to hit the bell icon so that you'll be notified for all the updates. So I have layered my cake layer with some whipping cream, and I'm gonna put another layer on top of that which I've already soaked with the sugar syrup, and now we're gonna crumb coat our cake. So crumb coating is really important as it prevents the cake crumbs from popping up in your finished cake. And basically crumb coat also helps fill in any gaps between your cake layers to create a solid surface before adding a smooth and final coat. So after crumb coating, I'm gonna put my cake for around 30 minutes in the fridge, and after that I'm gonna layer it finally. So let me scrape out all the extra whipping cream and give it a final touch of whipping cream. And after this final touch, we're gonna decorate it with some confettis and some sprinkles. Hope you guys enjoy watching this recipe. Until next time, take care, bye-bye, and keep watching Salt and Sugar Saga.